We're going to talk about forces. Forces are how two bodies interact, how they communicate. It's a push or a pull. And we're going to talk about, in particular, how force yields acceleration for kinematics. How force provides a change of energy, where work is equal to the change of energy is equal to force times distance. And also, force can transfer momentum from one body to another. So change in momentum is equal to force times a little bit of time that goes by. All right, so you saw how I can accelerate. We talked about 1 meter per second squared, where I'm moving at 1 meter per second, no meters per second, 1 meter per second. So you look, if we were in outer space, what you would see is this 70 kilogram object, my body, and there's an acceleration in this direction. And so you're thinking, there's got to be a force providing that. And you'd be looking for the rope on me that would have a force equal to my mass times my acceleration. Well, what's that? That's 70 kilograms times 1 meter per second squared, or 70 kilogram meters per second squared, or 70 newtons. Okay, how much is 70 newtons? Well, it's enough to make me accelerate at 1 meter per second squared. We could also put it in terms of gravity. It would be, what did we say? 10 newtons is the force on 1 kilogram. So this would be the force of gravity on 7 kilograms, or equal to the force of about 15, 16 pounds. So we have this idea of conservation of momentum and conservation of energy. And then I just told you we can change them with force. Now, how is this not a violation of conservation laws? If you have a system of bodies, they should have the same amount of energy in them at all times, unless you add them from somewhere else. Okay, so you could add them by heating it up, but you could also add them by sticking your hand in here with this force and pushing them. Certainly you could imagine that happening. You could imagine taking a body with very little energy and pushing it. And then it had some kinetic energy from the work I did. But conservation of energy states that that energy had to come from somewhere. And in this case, what we talked about is it comes from my muscles, right? My muscles transformed the chemical potential energy in my body, that was ATP, turned into force times the distance that my hand had to move, turned to kinetic energy, right? And of course, along the way, there's some energy lost to heat. And none of these processes are perfectly efficient, okay? So force can change the energy of something by doing work, but that work does have to come from an external source. And if it's not external, for instance, we could make our system bigger, and then we could say all the energy in the system was conserved by turning some of the energy in the system, this chemical energy, to some kinetic energy of the other part of the system. It's kind of the same for momentum. You could have a system of bodies interacting, let's say two masses on a spring bouncing around, and they'd have a certain amount of momentum. And it wouldn't change unless, again, my hand came down here and pushed them really hard, and then they would get some impulse, some change in momentum. But if you looked at me, I'd have the same impulse in the opposite direction, because that force that I put on them is the same as the force that they put on me. So you can see there's a force can be acting between two bodies. For instance, the repulsive force of my legs. And I can exert a force on this body. But you can see there's also a force acting on me that's the same force or repulsion between the two bodies. And again, if you drew a bigger picture in space and you said, here's Pete, with his hand hanging down, his hand hanging up like that. As he pushes on them, this whole system, if it were tied together by a rope, you'd find that its momentum would be conserved. It would have to be the same. So in this sense, force can provide acceleration. Force times the distance we move is work, which is a change of energy that we can give a system. That energy has to come from another energy source, conserve energy. And force times time will give me momentum. Of course, in conserving momentum, we recognize the momentum that I give to another body is the opposite of the momentum I gain from the interaction. Just like you saw, I kicked the chair one way, I get kicked the other way. Let's check units. Force times distance, that would be a newton times a meter. A newton meter is a joule unit of energy, or a newton is a kilogram meter per second squared times meter. A kilogram meter squared per second squared, yeah, is a joule unit of energy. Let's check units. Force times time, that would be a newton times a second. That's a kilogram meter per second squared times a second is equal to kilogram meter per second. Excellent. Mass times velocity.